Now, coming to the third topic, which was in the news on Saturday, death penalty. Basically, it was not a topic of death penalty, but it was somewhat related to the death penalty. So I am taking the whole topic in a comprehensive way. Before starting the topic of death penalty and before discussing this, I will raise three or four questions and will answer that. After answering, you will find that the topic gets completed. Okay? First question is, why death penalty? Why death penalty? Second one is, what is the scenario in India with respect to death penalty? What is the scenario in India with respect to death penalty? Third one, what are the different Supreme Court observations? With respect to capital punishment. Fourth one is whether to abolish or not to abolish the capital punishment. Whether to abolish or not death penalty. These are the four questions. Now, the first question is, why death penalty? Because there must be some observation by the person who has devised the death penalty concept. What was his observation? His observation was based on some empirical evidence. So, the idea was to ensure justice. There are different aspects of justice. What are the different aspects of justice? I will firstly mention that. First is distributive justice. Distributive justice. Basically, it amounts to the fairness. All should get the fair due according to the worth. Second one is restorative justice. Restorative justice. The basic example through which you can understand what is restorative justice, that if you have done something wrong and asked for an apology, it means you have restored the dignity of the person through on which you have committed any mistake. This comes under restorative justice. Third is procedural justice. Procedural justice means the process through which there is a distribution of resources must be fair. Then the procedure should be fair, automatically the outcome will be fair. This is the idea of procedural justice. Fourth is retributive justice. Retributive justice. Here the death penalty comes under retributive justice. Then what is retributive justice? Retributive justice means crime committed or offense must be proportional to the punishment. Or you can also say that punishment must be proportional to the amount or the magnitude of the crime committed by the person. The student of political science and international relations have heard about David Miller. David Miller also says that the punishment should not be too harsh, should not be too lax. It should be in proportion to the crime committed. Okay, now the first question gets completed. And why death penalty? Second is, what is the current scenario? Current scenario in India is, according to the Cornell Law School, according to Cornell Law School, 371 people in India are under the sentence of death, or you can say under capital punishment, but they have not been executed. Do you know that only 3 persons have been executed in last 11 years? Have been executed in last 11 years. Recent one is Yakub Menon. This is the current scenario. That okay? 371 people and only 3 persons have been executed in last 11 years. Now, why I have mentioned that this is the current scenario, this will highlight, or you can put in your arguments, why capital punishment should not be abolished, because according to the Cornell Law School, only 3 persons have been executed in the last 11 years. It means states are not in habit of giving capital punishment, but it is giving capital punishment only when there is a terror or when the national security is threatened. Okay, therefore I have mentioned it. Always there is a purpose of mentioning what I have mentioned, there is always some purpose. Now, Supreme Court observation. In Bachchan Singh case, because this was the first case with respect to death penalty in 1980, Supreme Court was of the view that there should be some doctrine of the rarest of the rare case. Why the Supreme Court has told that there should be a condition of the rarest of the rare case? Because some of the cases are of such a heinous cases which shook the collective conscience of the society. Okay? But Supreme Court has not elaborated that what should be the guidelines of rarest of the rare doctrine. Therefore, I am mentioning here the rarest of rare cases. Supreme Court has simply mentioned about rarest of the rare case, but the question will automatically rise that what are the guidelines? How do you know that this one is the rarest of the rare case? Then again, in Machli Singh case in 1983, Supreme Court has given some of the guidelines that it will check any case based on 3 or 4 parameters and decide whether it is rarest of rare case or not. First is motive, second is magnitude, third is manner, fourth is personality. Personality of victim and murderer. Motive of the murderer, magnitude of the crime, manner in which crime has been committed, and personality of the victim and murderer. These are the 4 basic parameters which Supreme Court uses in deciding rarest of the rare case. But no one knows that what the judges think when they are deciding the rarest of the rare case, because you all have heard about the Tandoor case. In Tandoor case, the magnitude was very heinous. Okay, magnitude was very harsh. But Supreme Court has not awarded the rarest of rare case to the Tandoor case. Okay, therefore it is very surprising to understand that what is magnitude, what is manner. But this is the idea which the Supreme Court has given, and you will have to mention in your answer. Third one is Devender Singh Bhullar case. Devender Singh Bhullar. In this case, Supreme Court has commuted the death sentence of Devender Singh. Commutes death sentence. You all know that the power of commuting the death sentence has been precedent under Article 72. Therefore, government has asked that how and why Supreme Court has commuted a death sentence. The reason given by the Supreme Court was that there is an inordinate delay in execution. And secondly, there was mental health issue with Devender Singh. Mental health issue. This is the ground for clemency. Okay? But Supreme Court needs to give some guidelines. That what does inordinate delay means? Does it mean that execution has not been done in 2 or 3 years? It amounts to be a ground of clemency or not? Supreme Court has cleared it in Satrughan Chauhan case. Here, Supreme Court has mentioned some of the guidelines that inordinate delay of 7 to 11 years. Inordinate delay of 7 to 11 years is a ground for clemency. Second, whenever you are going to execute any murderer or any person who has committed the crime, you must give 14 days advance notice to his family. Free legal aid must be given to the murderer. Okay, these are the guidelines given by Supreme Court. In this case, Supreme Court has also said that the mercy petition, that the provision of mercy petition under Article 72 and Article 161 is a constitutional right, it is not a discretion. Therefore, the constitutional right given to all under Article 21 must be obeyed in all circumstances. When you are making an inordinate delay, basically you are violating the constitutional right of the person. Okay, this was the basic idea of the Supreme Court judges behind giving Satrudan Chauhan verdict. Okay, now what was my fourth question? My fourth question was whether to abolish or not. Now you will have to give argument and counter argument. Now I am giving argument. Yes, capital punishment, yes, must be abolished. Don't forget to mention it under block in your answer. First, what are the arguments you can give? The first argument is right to life under Article 21 is unconditional. Right to life is unconditional. Second argument is possibility of error. Can any person deny that in any activity there is no any possibility of error? Likewise, judges may also do some error in deciding the cases related to death penalty. Okay, if it is decided that there has been done some error after executing the person, then what is this? It may be termed as a crime committed by the state. Okay, and this question has been raised by Amnesty International. Third is plight of weaker sections, or you can say poor people, because poor people does not have access to legal aid. When the people does not have an access to a legal aid, then it is against the principle of Article 38 to ensure justice to all. Okay, fourth one, there is no any scientific explanation to show that when you are retaining the capital punishment, there is a reduction in the crime rate. Okay, therefore, when there is no any reduction in the crime rate, then why do you retain the capital punishment? Retaining capital punishment and reduction in crime has no relation. Fifth, basically the death penalty, the idea of death penalty has entered into a domain of human rights. Now, it is not under the domain of the state that whether to take life of the people or not, because it is a human right discourse that you cannot take the life of people. So you can mention here, it has become a matter of human right discourse. And no right is above human rights. These are the arguments for abolishing capital punishment. You people can remember this 20th Law Commission. This is the report and the number is 20th. 20th Law Commission has forwarded or has told that there should be debate on how to abolish the death penalty. But there were some dissident members also in that group who have raised the question that there should be a difference between the people committed terror activities and people committed ordinary murder or ordinary crime. The debate is going on amongst the members of the Law Commission also, but 20th Law Commission has highlighted the issue to abolish the capital punishment. You can use it in an answer and it will give you an added advantage if you are mentioning Supreme Court cases and the number of the Law Commission in any GS paper 2 answer. Now, no, capital punishment should not be abolished. This will also be one of the arguments being forwarded by some sections of the society that no, capital punishment should not be abolished. Why it should not be abolished? Because the idea of the death penalty, I have told, is based on the retributive justice. And it is supported by the people who is supporting the retention of the capital punishment is idea of deterrence. Okay? Idea of deterrence. It means capital punishment deters people not to commit crime in future. Okay, but there is no any scientific explanation, but this is one of the argument given by the supporter of capital punishment. Second, India says that we follow rule of law. That we follow rule of law in awarding death penalty. But Supreme Court itself in 13 cases has highlighted that the rule of law has not been adhered. This is one of the sentence or one of the point which you can mention in yes, capital punishment should be abolished. That Supreme Court itself has acknowledged that 13 cases rule of law has not been adhered. Third one, sovereignty. India, being a sovereign country, is free to frame its own law, its own policy. Whether to go for death penalty or not will be decided by the lawmakers of India. It should not be dictated by any Amnesty International-like institution or any Paris Commune-like organization or UNHRC-like organization. Okay? Fourth, 354 clause 3 of CRPC. Remember it. All this will give you added advantage. Mind it. 354.3 of CRPC says judges must give reasons that why they are awarding death penalty. This is one of the safeguards available with the judges, and this is one of the reasons that the supporters of the capital punishment are always forwarding this argument that there is already a safeguard. The judges must give reasons. Okay? This is the argument for retention of capital punishment or non-abolition of capital punishment. Now this topic is completed. Now the problem with this topic is how to put conclusion. Okay? Because the government wants that the death penalty should continue, but there is a general discourse in the society, or there is a human rights discourse in the society that it should be abolished. Then you people are in confusion. Okay, now what to do? Conclusion. Yes, death penalty should be abolished, but there should be differentiation between the crime committed by terrorists and the crime committed by the ordinary citizens. Okay, this is the main idea which has also been forwarded by the Law Commission. Basically, what you are doing? You are supporting the Law Commission argument, but without mentioning the Law Commission. It will give an impression that you are putting your own idea. Okay, now, thank you, and now all the topics on the which came on the Saturday has been covered. Now in the next video will come with the next topic of the newspaper which has been covering international relation, political relation and GS paper 2. Okay, thank you.